Hello everyone, it's Tim Spector here of the ZOE COVID Symptom Study, giving you my interpretation of this week's data. And it's not quite as optimistic as last week when we talked about vaccines, because the number of new cases overall is staying fairly steady at about 35,000. That's down a little bit on last week, but not massively so. And the reason we're seeing this static picture and an R value that's close to one is because we're seeing a very different picture across the country. And that's why it's very hard to summarize everything that's going on in one single value, which I think is really important. So what's happening is that around five areas of the country, the UK are decreasing in numbers, and five areas of the country are increasing in numbers. So this is part of the way the pandemic happens, and maybe nothing whatsoever to do with the recent national lockdown. It might just be those tier effects working. So the Northwest is coming down nicely, Northeast, Scotland, Wales, all doing well. The Midlands is still rising despite national lockdown, and we're not exactly sure why. You've got London is pretty flat, and you've got the areas that were quite low slowly increasing. Nothing particularly worrying at the moment, because in those areas the bed capacity in the hospitals is okay. Last week the hospitals are about 85% full, which is what you'd expect at this time of year. And the government yesterday announced that the rise in hospitalizations, which is the real thing here, only rose by about 10% in the last week, which is not great, but it's not terrible either. The other reassuring sign is that we're not seeing an explosion in the over 60s across any of the regions, which makes us more confident this isn't going to cripple the NHS. So some cautious optimism, though it would be nice to next week report that things are started to move down in most of the areas, not just half of them. Also, a quick note that the R value we calculate is very much up to date. It's based on the last week's data, and some of the government R's you're getting are based on modelling, based on deaths and hospital figures, which by the time they report them are actually very out of date. So bear in mind that not all R statistics are the same. The key is to look at the actual numbers and how they're changing week on week, both in hospitals and in new cases and in ITU and capacity. So the picture for the winter is looking like we should get over this second wave with the social distancing measures. And I still predict we should be okay for Christmas before then having another upsurge again, which is likely. And the more you compress populations and release them, the more this will happen. Okay, so the other thing I want to mention is that we have a fantastic Q&A on vaccines with Peter Openshaw next Wednesday, which you can look at live or after the event. Just sign up through the website, and this will be all the latest questions you have about vaccines, whether to take them, whether not take them, which ones, who's going to be first affected, etc. So keep in tune with that. Keep logging. It's incredibly valuable to have independent data that's up to date, and you guys are doing a fantastic job. Thank you.